of January 2022. Before we begin, let me read the rules during this event. To all participants in the Zoom application, use the name with the format institution underscore name, and to all participants, wear neat and polite clothes. And to all participants in the Zoom application, are requested to activate the video and mute the microphone during this minute. And for participants who do not comply with the rules, the committee will remind 3 times, and after being reminded, the participant doesn't obey, the committee will remove he or she from the Zoom room. And to all participants must fill in the attendance form given by the committee through the Zoom chat room or YouTube comment column. And in discussion session, participants' questions are facilitated through the chat room Zoom or YouTube comment column by typing name underscore S1 or S2 or S3 underscore question. S1, it means speaker 1, or S2, it means speaker 2, and S3, it means speaker 3. Well, ladies and gentlemen, and I'd like to say thank you to all the participants of joining the webinar today. I hope you can participate this event until the end. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
The respected advisor of the Dewi Puspita Educational Foundation, Mr. Yadi Fakhruzzin Terangjaya SAMM, and the distinguished the head of the Dewi Puspita Educational Foundation, Mr. Iis Setiawan. Mr. Iis Setiawan Mangkunagara Eskom MTI, and the Excellency Rector of Harapan Bangsa University, Mrs. Dr. Pramesti Dewi MKes, and the Honorable, the Head of Social Faculty of Harapan Bangsa University, Mr. Alfizi SAMM, and the Honorable, the Head of English Education Department of Harapan Bangsa University, Mrs. Tri Pujiani MPD, and the Honorable Mrs. Hairun Nisa and Mr. Dimas Sasongko as the speakers today. Good morning, Bu Nisa and Pak Dimas. All right, the Honorable Distinguished, the Head of Primary Teacher Education Study Program of Teacher Training and Education Faculty of Universitas Muhammadiyah, Mr. Agristo Bintang Aji Pranana, MPD, and the Honorable Lecturers and all the staff of Harapan Bangsa University, and respectable ladies and gentlemen, the participants of this event. First of all, let us praise unto our God because His blessing we can gather together without any obstacles. I'm Abila Mika, the student of English Education Department, Harapan Bangsa University. I'm very pleased to be the master of ceremony in this event today because as we know that learning media is inseparable from the learning process. It plays an important role in the success of the learning. So by joining this webinar, we can get full of knowledge and insight from the speaker. Well, today we have several agendas follow. The first agenda is opening. The second agenda is listening National Anthem Indonesia Raya. And the third agenda is welcoming speech. And the fourth agenda is presentation of the speaker. And the fifth agenda, discussion session and quiz. And the last agenda is closing. Well, the next agenda is listening to National Anthem Indonesia Raya. Dear ladies and gentlemen, we go to the next agenda, namely welcoming speech. The first speech will be given by the Rector of Harapan Bangsa University, Mrs. Dr. Pramesti Dewi MKS. The time and screen are yours.
Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat pagi dan salam sejahtera untuk kita semua. Yang saya hormati, Fakultas Sosial Universitas Harapan Bangsa, Bapak Alfizi SEMM. Yang saya hormati narasumber kegiatan webinar hari ini, Ibu Tri Pujiani MPD, Ibu Khairunisa Eskom Mkom, serta Bapak Dimas Sasongko Eskom MEng. Yang terhormat Kaprodi PGSD Universitas Muhammadiyah Magelang, Bapak Agristo Bintang Aji Pradana MPD, serta seluruh peserta webinar yang berbahagia. Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin, puji syukur selalu kita panjatkan kepada Allah Subhanahu wa taala sehingga kita dalam keadaan sehat bisa mengikuti kegiatan webinar yang diadakan oleh Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris Universitas Harapan Bangsa dengan tema Innovative Language Teaching Media in the Digital Era. Ucapan terima kasih saya sampaikan kepada panitia webinar, teman-teman dosen PBI Universitas Harapan Bangsa yang telah mempersiapkan acara ini dengan baik. Sehingga kegiatan webinar hari ini bisa diikuti oleh semua peserta dari berbagai profesi maupun instansi. Bapak, Ibu, serta rekan-rekan mahasiswa peserta webinar, perkembangan era digital yang semakin pesat menuntut kita para pendidik untuk terus berkembang, terus kreatif, dan inovatif agar dapat memfasilitasi para peserta didik untuk mencapai kompetensi-kompetensi yang diharapkan. Tidak bisa dipungkiri kemajuan teknologi menuntut guru dan dosen untuk mengaplikasikan media pembelajaran yang lebih relevan. Media pembelajaran tidak hanya digunakan untuk menyampaikan materi ajar, akan tetapi juga harus dapat menumbuhkan ketertarikan dan rasa keingintahuan hingga pada akhirnya peserta didik termotivasi untuk belajar. Para hadirin peserta webinar yang berbahagia, tujuan webinar hari ini adalah untuk mewadahi karya para akademisi, baik guru, dosen, maupun peneliti untuk berbagi pengetahuan dan pengalaman terkait dengan media pembelajaran terkini yang layak untuk diaplikasikan di era digital. Selamat menimba ilmu dari para narasumber, semoga banyak manfaat yang didapat dari kegiatan hari ini. Kiranya hanya ini yang bisa saya sampaikan. Sebelum saya tutup, dengan mengucap bismillahirrahmanirrahim, secara resmi saya buka webinar Innovative Language Teaching Media in the Digital Era. Terima kasih. Billahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much. The second welcoming speech will be delivered by the Head of Primary Teacher Education Study Program of Universitas Muhammadiyah Magelang, Mr. Agristo Bintang Aji Pradana MPD. The time and screen are yours.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrofil anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbi ajmain amma ba'du. Oke. Distinguished rector, distinguished dean and honorable the head of department, faculty members and then ladies and gentlemen. I'm from Primary Teacher Education Department of Universitas Muhammadiyah Magelang. First of all, I would like to thank the rector and the dean and the head of department of Harapan Bangsa University for inviting me and my students to participate in this great occasion, actually. And the pandemic changes almost all aspects in human life, including education. And then the question is, how is education responding to these changes? And then the learning has been shifting from face-to-face method where teacher should interact with the students directly to the new one where technology is integrated into teaching and learning process. And here now students can learn anything, anywhere and anytime. One of the keys is teacher's role actually, and it is about how teacher play their roles as facilitator and then motivator, and they need to know how to teach their students learning and living with technology. So this webinar is, I think, quite important for us, for a lecture, for students to open our mind as a response to this digital era. And then this existing curriculum actually in higher education changes as well. And students are now expected to have an agile mind. They can learn from anyone and any source. That's why I ordered my students from learning innovation classes to join this seminar, to participate in webinar, and perhaps they will learn not only in their major, but also in their in other ones, including English education. Who knows, one day from this webinar, there will be so many innovation in language teaching and learning. And finally, I really appreciate, as the rector said before, to the committee for organizing this wonderful occasion. And I'm really expecting that one day, next time, we together will create such great agenda. Okay, thank you. That's all. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi.
Thank you very much for the speech. Well, ladies and gentlemen, before we start the event, let us take photo together. And to all participants, please activate the video.
Hello.
All right, slide one. Slide two. And the last slide. Thank you. Now let's we move to the main agenda we have been waiting for, and we will be guided by a moderator. It is now my pleasure to introduce the moderator. He is Mr. Benny Krisbiantoro, MPD, an English language lecturer at Harapan Bangsa University since 2015, and he was graduated from Master of English Education Department at 11 Maret University in 2013, and his expertise in teaching English skills specifically on speaking and writing. And his motto, live and let live. So now please welcome Mr. Benny to guide this main agenda. The time and screen are yours.
Well, thank you very much to the Master of Ceremony to give me the big chance to chair this virtual seminar. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam.
Good morning, everyone. The Honorable Rector of Universitas Harapan Bangsa, Ibu Dr. Pramesti Dewi Mkes. The Honorable Vice Rector One of Universitas Harapan Bangsa, Ibu Nurse Murniati Eskop Mkep. The Honorable Vice Rector II Universitas Harapan Bangsa, Ibu Dr. Yuristri Naili, SHMHKM. The Honorable Dean of the Faculty of Social Sciences, Bapak Alfizi, SAMM, along with all staffs. Our distinguished speakers, Ibu Tri Pujiani, MPD, Ibu Khairun Nisa, MCOM, and Bapak Dimas Asongko, SCOM, MI. And the Honorable all participants of this virtual seminar. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Benny Crispiantoro, the moderator of today's webinar. I'm very pleased to see you here and welcome all of you to this virtual seminar. Today's webinar is about innovative language teaching media in the digital era. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we see a huge loss from this COVID-19 pandemic. School closures, school drops out, students' mental health disorders, etc., are some of the many impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic. Therefore, we, as educators, must be able to optimize ourselves in preparing innovative and interesting teaching media so that we can reduce the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic itself. With me, there are three speakers who are experts in the field of teaching and learning media. We have Ms. Annie. Good morning, Ms. Annie.
Morning, Mr. Benny.
And we also have Ms. Nisa or Ibu Nisa. Good morning, Bu Nisa. And then we have Bapak Fajar. Good morning, Pak Fajar. Well, ladies and gentlemen, our speakers today are Ibu Tri Pujiani, MPD, who is going to talk about learning media for young learners. Ibu Khairun Nisa, with her presentation topic, multi-platform of educational games. And Bapak Dimas Asongko, whose topic of his presentation is about interactive teaching media design. Before the presentation begins, let me inform how the presentation will be going on. First, the presentations of the material by all speakers, and the allocated time is for about 20 minutes for each speaker. Second, the Q&A session, and last is the conclusion. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the main event of this webinar that we've been waiting for, the presentation by our first presenter. The first presentation about learning media for young learners will be delivered by Ibu Tri Pujiani, MPD. Now let's invite Ibu Tri Pujiani, MPD to join our webinar today. Good morning, Miss Annie. How are you today?
Morning, Mr. Benny. I'm very good.
Very nice, Ibu Annie. Thank you very much for your willingness to be one of the speakers in our webinar. Well, ladies and gentlemen, before Miss Annie presents her material, I'd like to read her CV. Miss Annie is the head of English Education Department as well as Language Development Center of Universitas Harapan Bangsa. She's obtained her master and bachelor degree of English Language Education, 11 Maret University, Surakarta. She's also a member of English Language Education Study Program Association and Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages International Organization. Her expertise is on English language teaching media. Well, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please welcome Ms. Tri Pujiani.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Benny, for giving the first chance to me as the first presenter. Now, let me share the screen. Wait a second. Can you see my slideshow? Okay, so Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. As mentioned by the moderator, that today I'm going to talk about learning media, especially for young learners. But anyway, here I'm not alone because I will be assisted by my students as well as my research assistants. They are Nelia Al-Mustafliha and Rizky Fitriani, who will present the learning media that they made. They are animation video and storybook. Okay, without any further ado, let me start my presentation. First, let's define what learning media is. A learning media is non-personal thing used by a teacher to convey the learning message as well as motivate the students and stimulate their mind, feeling, interest, and attention. So there are three main points here. The first, media is non-personal thing. And the function is to convey the learning message, and the purpose is to motivate and also to stimulate the students. Okay, so next, why is the use of learning media important in the process of learning? First, it can avoid the barriers of communication, including verbalism, misinterpretation, unfocused attention, and also lack of understanding. And next, the use of media can concretize the abstract idea, as what said, and concrete abstract continuum principle, that the students will learn something concrete easier rather than the abstract one. And then the next, the use of learning media can also overcome the students' limitation, including the limitation of experience, the limitation of socioeconomic, and maybe about the disabilities. And then if the media used is interesting, of course, it can motivate the students and also stimulate learning. And now let's define our learning target. The learning target are young learners, and young learners are children from the first year of formal schooling. They are children age 5 to 12 years old. So when we send our children to school for the first time, then they are young learners. Usually they are early childhood education students, kindergarten students, and elementary students. And in developing a learning media, it's very important to understand the characteristic of the students. So here, I will share some main characters of young learners. The first, they have a great curiosity to try new things. The second, they actively construct meaning from their experience. And the third, they have a quite short attention span and are easy to get bored. And then the fourth, young learners are active learners and thinkers. And then the fifth, young learners are eager to talk about themselves. What I mean here that young learners usually more interested to something that relate to them, and they feel involved during the discussion. And then the last, young learners tend to be interested to something imaginative, colorful, and full of cheerful music. Those are the characteristics of young learners. Well, young learners are unique, aren't they? And teaching English to young learners is challenging, especially for the teacher. And moreover, during the pandemic of COVID-19, it's very a difficult time for all educators, I guess, because the teacher were required to transform the learning activities from the offline to online activities. I guess it's not easy for us, but also now we are moving out from the pandemic, and we are in the post-pandemic era, but we cannot just forget the pandemic, because we cannot deny that we learned many things during the pandemic, right? Based on my observation, yeah, in the implementation of learning from home, usually teachers use a WhatsApp group as the media of communication, and then distributing worksheet, giving assignment, and sometimes providing learning video. And it's not easy at all. Many challenges must be faced from teachers and also the parents. And then from the teacher's point of view, the challenge include how to prepare the learning activities and also how to keep learning achievement on target. Yeah, is it? Preparing the online learning activities needs more time and effort. And the teachers or the lecturers also need to make sure that the learning activities that we provide were applicable at home. And within all the limitations during the pandemic, we cannot avoid that the students' learning achievement was a little bit decreased. And from the parents' point of view, as the teacher's partner in guiding the students to learn at home, the challenge including how to make conducive learning situation at home. Yeah, of course, the atmosphere at home and in school is different. And based on the previous research, from 10 parents, only 3 of them can provide good learning situation at home. So it can be very stressful for both the parents and also the students. And then for working parents, especially working mom, and the challenge, including how to manage the role conflict. Yeah, this is very crucial. I also feel that because the parents also need to work at home. So there is a role conflict there. And then how to manage burnout and how to manage the time. Well, considering this phenomenon, and then I and my research assistant tried to develop a learning media that can facilitate the students to learning independently at home. They are animation video and storybook. Yeah, also now, as I said before, that we are moving out from the pandemic and going to be in post-pandemic era, but I guess this media is still applicable to be applied in class, especially for English for young learners. Okay, so without any further ado, let me show you the learning media. The first, this is an animation video that will be presented by Nelia Al-Mustafliha. For your information, she is the fifth semester student of English Education Department of Harapan Bangsa University. And she is one of the outstanding students of Harapan Bangsa University since she has ever been the second winner of Creative Video SF Fest 2020 and the second winner of Scientific Festival National Speech Contest. Nelia Al-Mustafliha, are you there? Sorry, I cannot hear you.
Yes, miss, I'm here. Yes, I'm here.
Okay, great. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is Nelia Al-Mustafliha. Nelia, the screen is yours.
Oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you are always healthy. Thank you very much for the opportunity to present. Well, on this occasion, I would like to tell you about a learning media that I developed, which is animation video. I made this by using Game Master and Zepeda application that can be downloaded in Play Store. Before starting to the step of animation video, let's see the clip of animation video. The theme is progression, the learner target is young learners. The learning objective, the students are able to maintain transportation and describe adjectives and workplaces. Language feature are vocabulary verb and simple present. Language skills is integrated skills, including listening, reading, speaking, and writing. Okay, let's see the clip of animation video.
Hi, how are you doing? Welcome to Fun English Course. I'm Nelia, you can call me Miss Ni. What do you want to be when you grow up? Doctor? Teacher? Or pilot? Wow, nice! Today, we're going to learn about profession. Are you ready? Let's go. are we? Yeah, we are in the hospital. And who are they? Right, they are doctors. What does a doctor do? A doctor heals sick patients. Well, where else will we go? Hi, doctor. What does a teacher do? Great. A teacher teaches students at school. Where does a waitress work? Nice. A waitress works at the restaurant. Excellent. Pilot. Well done, kids. Now, do you mind telling us your parents' profession? You can tell us about your father or your mother. Please tell us their profession, their workplace, and their duty. Thank you all. See you next time.
Okay, just a quick examination video. This media has been implemented in the kindergarten protocol. And when developing this media, I also asked for feedback from some of the students. There are material expert, media expert, young learners, teacher, and parents as the users. And their response was very good. For the score given, you can see on the table. As you can see on the table, the score from material expert is 82. For the score from media expert is 84. The score from young learners teacher is 98. And the average score from the parents is 82. So the average of the total score is 86.5. It belongs very good grade. Well, there isn't any perfect media. This media has some benefits and risks. For the benefit, first, it facilitates students with different learning styles and audiovisual. As we know that each student has different learning styles, such as auditorial, visual, and kinesthetic. Second, it was designed by considering children's characteristics. I mean, the character, the background, the music, the word choice, and so on. And last, it provides review and follow-up activity at the end of the video. And for the weakness, I think the media is good for reading and or input for the teacher because it's less interactive. There is only one-way communication. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much, Nelia Al-Mustafliha, for very incredible learning video. Okay, and now let's see the second learning media. It is a storybook made by Rizky Fitriani. She is also the fifth semester student of English Education Department of Harapan Bangsa University. And she has several achievements, such as the second winner of Poster SLFest 2020, the second winner of Short Story Writing Hudex Online National English Competition, and the third winner of Cover Song Competition. Rizky Fitriani, are you ready?
Yes, Miss, I'm ready.
Okay, great. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, this is Rizky Fitriani. The screen is yours.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. I wish you in a good health ways. Thank you very much for the chance given to me to explain how to make an history book. Well, in this occasion, I will explain about a history book. I made it by using ebook creator. You can find it on your browser. Before we started, let's see the detail of the learning media. The theme is I and my family. Learner target is young learner. Learning objective is the students are able to introduce themselves and their family members. And language feature are vocabulary verb and simple present. And language skill is integrated skill, including listening, reading, speaking, and writing. Now, let's see the history book.
Wait a second, Rizky Fitriani is trying to share her screen to share us of the history book.
Okay, now can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, this is the book. The title is Tuya's Diary. Click read now. Okay, in here you can play the sound by read to me.
Hello, everyone. How are you today? I'm Malia. You can call me Lia. L-I-A. I am 6 years old. I live in Pure Walker, too. I like dancing. Dancing makes me happy.
Okay, but if we read to me, the sound will look like robot. So I also provide audio recorded by myself, so the sound will look natural.
Hello, everyone. How are you today? I'm Amalia. You can call me Lia. L-I-A. I'm 6 years old. I live in Purwokerto. I like dancing. Dancing makes me happy.
Okay, that's it. And here there are some blue words. And if we click the word, it will immediately open to the glossary. For example, we click the word you. Okay, and immediately open to the previous page. And in the previous page, there are a pronoun, personality, family tree, vocabulary, jobs, the English alphabet, and number. And if you go to the previous page, just click the word you again. And it will immediately show the student it will learn easily. Okay, that's it. The overview of e-storybook. Wait a second.
Well, just wait a moment, it's still loading. Sorry. Okay, go on.
Okay. This media has been tried out to kindergarten students near my house. In developing this media, first I conducted pre-preparation and then started designing the media. And then asked for feedback from material expert and media expert. After that, I consulted to young learner teacher. And finally, I asked to feedback to the parents. Okay, and for following is a table of average scores given by respondent. The score for material expert is 84. The score for media expert is 94. The score from young learner teacher is 91. And the average score from the parent is 80. So the average of the total score is 87.25. It belongs to very good grade. Okay. Well, in this media also has some benefit and weakness. For the benefit, I think it is quite the same as animation video made by Nelia. First, it facilitates students with different learning styles since it is audiovisual. Second, it was designed by considering children characteristics. Third is provide list of related vocabulary at the back of the book. And fourth, it facilitates self-learning since the children can operate it by themselves and they can check the vocabulary back and forth. And for the weakness, when we open this media, we need to connect to the internet. So I think this is a homework for me to make it more accessible. Okay, that's all for me. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. What amazing learning media, Rizky Fitriani. Thank you very much. Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's all our presentation about learning media for young learners and animation video and also storybook. And here we realize that our learning media is still far from perfect, so we are open for any suggestion. And maybe if there is any of you are interested to our learning media, we can have research collaboration maybe to develop our media to be better and better. So just feel free to contact me at this email. I would really appreciate that. Okay, so that's all from us. Thank you very much for your attention. I'll give the time back to the moderator. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much to Miss Annie, Nelia, and Vivi for delivering such an applicable, informative, and interesting material. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the next presentation about multi-platform of educational games will be given by Ibu Khairunnisa, MCOM. Well, let's invite Bu Nisa. Bu Nisa, good morning.
Good morning, Mr.
Before Bu Nisa delivers her presentation, I will read her bio. Bu Nisa is a lecturer of Informatics Engineering Study Program of Harapan Bangsa University. She's graduated from Informatics Engineering Bachelor Degree of Muhammadiyah University of Surakarta, and she's taken her Master of Informatics Engineering from AMICOM University of Yogyakarta. She's ever worked at Mutiara Solusindo Incorporated, Jakarta, as an IT consultant, an IT support at PKU Muhammadiyah Hospital Sukoharjo, and she's joined several organizations like Apticom and Mugi Purwokerto. Her expertise is on DSS and RPLA. To Ibu Nisa, time and screen are yours.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Okay, let me start screen. Okay. Today we are going to discuss about multi-platform of educational games. Okay, sub-discussion today. The first, I will explain to you about effective use of EduGame. This is a presented I took from journal. In picture one, it is perception of teacher and student of EduGame. And then picture two, subject area digital EduGame for early childhood. We can look this percentage in blended and then mathematics and then literature and language. Maybe someone here is asking, what is multi-platform? If a software program is developed for multiple operating systems, it is considered to be multi-platform. Example, we can run application or software in Android or Windows or Linux and etc. And on this occasion, I want to make an education game using Construct 2, but I want to discuss about Construct 2. Construct 2 is HTML5 Basecamp or application make software specially for the 2D platform or two dimension. This software was developed by Jira. You can download the construct or software construct too in URL HTML www.construct.net. In this, and with tipe R221. When we make design for element game, this is reference. You can reference for color, for design, and so on. Color in URL colorhood.co, and then design in prepick.co or dribble.com, and then you can make a voice from text to voice in URL voicemaker.in. Okay, let's get start making your first edu game with Construct 2. Previously, we install Construct 2. We've already construct two. Then first pack like this. Look at this, like other application. Here there are menu file, same other application file. Home, and then view, event, and then property, project, and object. In start pack, we click this new project for with software or application. And then, okay, I'm sorry. And then select template. I usually need new empty project. And then this, we set a property for layer. This is a layout. Then you can bring your element. Then click layout, this for edit layout property in left layout. In this name, you can rename layout this. Example, I want to create layout menu. And then I want to set layout size. In with layout, I want to 700 and then 5 and then we set margin same with layout size. 700, and then don't forget to set a windows. You can click in configuration setting, click view, kemudian then is same 7 and 500. Okay, we can give a background. Right click in this layout and then click insert new background for add something, object or element. And then pop up insert new object, select the sprint, and then in here can you name sprint, example background, menu background. And then click insert. Click in layout. This. Then this. You select open folder to select picture. Example, I want to select background. Next, open. Then in result. Okay. I want to portray landscape. No landscape. Finally, we can create one layout menu. This background. You can resize with four. This in this in object type. And then I want to give a menu button, same with insert to background. Right click and then insert new object, same. And then click sprint, give name sprint. Example, learn button. And then I click insert. Click in layout again. Sam, click icon folder. And then choose learn picture. Click open. Don't forget to crop. Okay, finally, we can input button learning. I want to input once again button quiz. The step is same. Sprint, and then name. Click insert and then click in the layout. Same, click folder. Select picture. Click open. Okay. The next step. We must create layout learning because next learning layout. In the layout, this layout, right click. And then add layout. Don't forget to add event seat. This is a for event seat action. Same then. Yeah. Reset this. Layout, same menu, layout. Layout says, the margin, same. And then we can insert an element or object for background learning. Click right, and then click insert new object. Same then, click sprint. This give name sprint. Example, background. Learn. And then I click this insert, click in layout. We select picture, same them, background. You can reference or you can create the picture in MS PowerPoint, or you can put in reference example, in Frapik or in dribble.com. Click open. Don't forget to crop. Okay. This we set again. You can input learning. Example, we input learning about family. I want to insert again. Click right, insert object. Click insert. Same, click in the layout. Next, click layout, select picture. I want to select picture or grandpa. And then click open. Same. I want to set again. In the example, I want to create game for learn English language and Indonesia. I insert again because I need button for play song language English and Indonesia. Right click, insert again. Yes. English button. Click insert. Same, click in layout, and then select button, example this, click open. Set resize. And then I click insert new again for button language Indonesia. I want to set again. Finally, we have two buttons, language Indonesia and English. Yes. Finally, we have two layouts. One layout menu, and then two layout learning. That's we can application this camp. Okay, don't forget give icon button home. Same step. Right click insert new object again. Home button. And then click insert. And then click this. Select home. Open. You can this or this. Okay. Don't forget to save. The steps same with save word or PowerPoint, set the URL, save. Okay, to try this game without input. Click in button run layout for two watching layout create. Don't forget to setting preview in this because we can select any more preview. Example Chrome or Firefox or Opera in this Chrome. Okay. And then I run layout. Finally, is results. But this is can click because we create a event sheet. Can click. Okay, next step we make event sheet.
Excuse me, Bu Nisa, you yes? Still have two more minutes.
Okay. Okay. Run. Yes. And then I want to even. Don't forget add even for this because in this construct we need difficult program, but we can input event or action. Yes. Click this. Okay, I forget insert search bar, click this cam touch, sir. In this event, at even touch or click, then on to avoid object, and then next. And then select or choose your object to click. Example, done button. Okay. This event. And then I want to give action. Click action system. Go to the layout learn. Okay. And then click learn layout learn, click done. Okay, kita retry. And results this click can to the move layout learn. Okay, I want to demonstrate as a game, as a edu game zone apps. In this, I'm export project can in Windows or Linux or operation system other. This, I have once this. I want to demonstrate. Yes, this is a English zone apps, and then we can give some effect. Example, I want to click button learn, and then move to layout learning. I'm select in at home. And then this, when click the this, kan seperti ini. Then X, okay. This, Mister, my presentation. Thank you for.
Thank you very much, Bu Nisa, for delivering such user-friendly application and teach us how to create our own educational games. Well, I'd like to remind you all to fill out the attendance form shared in the Zoom and YouTube chat. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now moving along to the next presentations, please welcome Bapak Dimas Sasongko, Eskom MM, who is going to present about interactive teaching media design. Welcome, Bapak Dimas.
Yes, thank you, Mr.
It's very glad to meet you. Before his presentation begins, I will read his CV. Bapak Dimas is a lecturer of Informatics Engineering Study Program of Universitas Muhammadiyah Magelang. His interests are on computer network science, system security, cloud computing, mobile apps, and UI or UX. Currently, he is commencing his research on serious games. Besides, he's the head of Students Achievement Development Division at his college. Also, he's the chief editor as well as the reviewer of several reputable journals. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now I'd like to turn over the time to Bapak Dimas.
Okay, thank you, Pak Benny. Good morning, everyone. Hello, my name is Dimas Sasongko. I'm from Universitas Muhammadiyah Magelang. And at this moment, I want to present presentation about interactive design. Okay, once again, I just can say thank you for the opportunity you've given for me, and maybe I want to please allow me to deliver this presentation using bahasa. Saya sedikit merasa luar biasa ini, banyak sekali tadi menyampaikan dengan bahasa Inggris, saya sedikit merasa insecure ini dengan teman-teman. Baik, mohon maaf Bapak Ibu, izin menyampaikan presentasi kali ini. Kami menggunakan bahasa Indonesia dan untuk melengkapi sesuai dengan temanya, yaitu berkaitan dengan isinya adalah pendidikan bahasa Inggris. Kemarin untuk materi presentasinya saya buat untuk mendukungnya dalam bahasa Inggris. Mohon maaf mungkin jika terdapat ada beberapa noise karena posisi kami saat ini sedang tidak ada di kantor, jadi ada di luar. Jadi mohon maaf sekali jika ada noise yang muncul. Baik, kenapa kita perlu membicarakan tentang interaktif design? Jadi kalau kita melihat di era sekarang saat ini bagaimana semua apa ya, semua media, semua materi itu kemudian di deliver ya menggunakan perangkat-perangkat yang memang saat ini, tapi saya melihat presentasi dari Bu Ani ya, saya baru tahu panggilannya Bu Ani. Bagaimana ketika membatasi usia anak sekarang usia 5 sampai dengan 12 tahun, dan kebetulan itu juga area research saya terkait serius game juga di usia anak-anak tersebut. Jadi sedikit banyak tadi melihat yang disampaikan juga istilahnya, oke, itu menambah insight banyak buat saya secara pribadi. Jadi media sekarang yang digunakan termasuk perangkat itu sangat luar biasa perkembangannya. Jadi bagaimana kemudian kita meng-create sebuah we create about teaching media, maybe we can say teaching media, or maybe we can say educational game, edugame, like that. Itu sangat-sangat mempengaruhi tergantung bagaimana kita mengawali itu dengan sebuah desainnya. Bagaimana kita mengawali proses tersebut. Nah, hari ini saya akan menyampaikan, saya bukan, disclaimer dulu bahwa saya tidak expert ya, saya bukan expert di bidang ini, tapi paling tidak beberapa insight yang saya pelajari selama ini tentang UI UX, tentang interaction design, kemudian juga saya sempat membaca di dalam edugame dan teaching media, mungkin dapat saya sedikit sharing pada kesempatan kali ini. Oke, okay. We can talk about agenda for today. Is number one is designing for student. Okay, I can say designing for student maybe at the another word is designing for people. And number two is we can say about organizing the content. We know about media, or maybe we can say at teaching media, the main point about the teaching media is a content. And number three is I want to explain about visual style, how we can create a teaching media more user friendly like that. And number four is to close with the interaction design. A central concern of interaction design is to develop interactive products that are usable. Jadi poin penting di sini adalah ketika kita membuat sebuah produk yang berkaitan dengan interaksi adalah memastikan bahwa produk itu bisa digunakan. Usability ini tadi Pak Polirunisa yang mempelajari di multimedia atau edukin pasti juga tidak asing dengan istilah tersebut. And by this we mean product that are generally easy to learn. Pasti adalah dia mudah untuk dipahami, effective to use, effective, and provide an enjoyable user experience. Salah satu hal yang saya tekankan adalah bahwa selain berguna, bahwa media, teaching media tersebut juga sesuai dengan pengalaman. Makanya tadi kenapa mungkin tadi Bu Ani memberikan batasan di usia 5 sampai dengan 12, ya berarti ketika meng-create teaching media tadi, Bu Ani akan membatasi pada usia-usia tersebut mereka memiliki experience seperti apa. Mungkin ketika menggunakan ilmu dulu dengan ilmu sekarang pasti akan berbeda. Bagaimana perkembangan-perkembangan anak itu seperti apa, pasti ketika meng-create-nya ini pasti akan kemudian menyesuaikan dengan usia mereka. Mungkin salah satu hal yang paling gampang untuk menilai sebuah produk ataupun kita akan mengawali itu bisa membandingkan dengan bagaimana desain yang buruk ataupun desain yang jelek. Tapi itu tidak kami bahas pada kesempatan ini. Okay, designing for student. I have a good word, but you are not the user. Ya, ini yang paling penting. Jadi kita sebagai guru, sebagai pengajar yang nantinya mungkin teman-teman mahasiswa yang akan meng-create sebuah aplikasi, posisikan bahwa kita bukan sebagai pembuatnya. Jadi siapa yang akan menggunakan ini? Jadi good interface teaching media doesn't begin with pictures. Maybe a lot of people say image is everything. Yeah, image is always a good point to start something, maybe like that, but that's not always like that. It begins with an understanding of student. We must be understanding what they are like and how they might interact with it. Example, with Mrs. Ani, usia anak di usia 5 sampai dengan 11 tahun tadi, dengan 12 tahun tadi, mereka suka yang seperti apa, kemudian mereka akan berinteraksi secara seperti apa. Nah, Bapak Ibu guru pun yang hadir pada hari ini pun sama. Pelajari, jadi tidak menggunakan ide bahwa saya adalah guru. Jadi ketika meng-create sebuah media pembelajaran tadi, gunakan bahwa saya membuat ini akan digunakan oleh murid saya. Saya mendesain ini akan digunakan untuk student saya. Oke, next. Sebetulnya ada 4 elemen, tapi saya ambilkan 2 elemen penting dulu di sini tuh untuk saya bahas, yaitu the first major element and the first step is designing for people is to people or student is to understand the human context for your design intention. Jadi pahami konteks. Jadi saya sampaikan, audiensnya siapa yang akan menggunakan aplikasi ini, apa ya, student dengan batasan usia berapa yang akan menggunakan media pembelajaran ini. Jadi interaction design start with defining and understanding the people who will use your design. Ini yang penting. Setelah memahami bahwa kita bukan sebagai pengguna, berikutnya pahami siapa audiensnya. And then especially ground your design decision in understanding what they may want to do and what they bring to the interaction in terms of expectation. Jadi berikutnya, kita setelah kita memahami, berikutnya adalah kita bicara goals-nya, tujuannya. Apa yang akan mereka capai dengan menggunakan teaching media tersebut. Jadi konteks ya, who is your audience, and dan berikutnya adalah goals. What are they trying to do? Okay, next. Nah, ini yang lumayan sering saya gunakan di awal, yaitu kita bicara tentang personas. Persona, yang ini di bahasa Indonesia persona. Jadi models the target audience. Jadi mungkin kita punya student jumlahnya 34 atau 36 misalkan, kita perlu membuat sebuah profil. Mungkin saya mengatakan kita tidak perlu kemudian membuat sebuah aplikasi yang akhirnya meng-hire semuanya, tapi cukup kita mendapatkan beberapa sampel satu atau dua personas. Mungkin kita membuat desain tadi berdasarkan kalau di sini nyebutnya ada proto person tadi. Jadi, dan itu pun misalkan kita pengen uji apakah aplikasi media pembelajaran tadi sudah sesuai atau belum dengan murid saya, ya diujikan cukup dengan satu atau dua berdasarkan persona tadi. Jadi ini who captures the most important aspect of the users in that group. Biasanya nama, kemudian jenis kelamin, karena bisa jadi antara laki-laki dan perempuan mungkin akan menghasilkan cara menggunakan media pembelajaran itu yang juga berbeda. Nah, di sini adalah personas can help you stay focused. Jadi dengan seperti ini kita tidak akan tadi seperti Bu Ani tadi di usia 5 sampai dengan 12. Nah, di persona untuk mencari persona anak usia 5-12 tadi sekarang yang paling banyak seperti apa? Dipilih satu atau dua, kemudian dibuat profilnya yang kemudian nanti kita fokus untuk membuat teaching media tadi berdasarkan persona tersebut. Okay, next we can talk about organizing the content. Information exchange is how the data, content, and functionality are organized in a way that makes sense for the people you're designing. Jadi, konten itu kan sesuatu yang menjadi sesuatu yang paling utama nanti di media pembelajaran misalkan. Ya, seperti itu. Nah, bagaimana kita menyusun kontennya, bagaimana kita membuat aliran dari masing-masing satu konten ke konten lainnya, itu perlu kita buat sebuah kayak semacam urutan intinya akan memudahkan. Okay, the purpose of information assistor is to create the framework for your digital product.
Nungkanang Arab teluk.
Service, site, or application to be successful. Jadi di sini dengan kita membuat sebuah, ini saya berikan sebuah contoh gambaran. Jadi kalau misalkan nanti di home, nanti misalkan Indonesia tadi membuat sebuah aplikasi edugame, nanti di home dia akan diisi apa, kemudian nanti dari home ada icon, ada tombol apa, itu akan mengarah kemana, dengan tampilan seperti apa, isinya apa. Nah, itu kita definisikan di awal. Dengan seperti itu, kita tidak akan menemui kesulitan yang sangat berarti ketika kita mulai meng-create. Pengalaman contohnya ketika kami kemarin meng-create sebuah mobile apps, dengan perancangan atau perencanaan yang cukup matang, dengan memakan waktu yang lama, misalkan 1 bulan, itu ketika kita berikan ke developer, dia hanya butuh waktu sekitar 1 minggu atau sampai dengan 10 hari, misalkan seperti itu. A critical part of this interactive experience is that the interface should not get in the way. Jadi jangan sampai bagian ini kemudian nanti ternyata malah membuat sulit. Jadi kita dari awal sudah bisa mengidentifikasi. Oke, di sini layer design, we start at data and content. We can make point in design is information architecture and navigation pattern. Today I want to explain just at this layer, data and content, and maybe we can explain a little in interaction design. Okay, how about the navigation? Kita mau nyusun navigasinya seperti apa nih? Ini perlu kita petakan di awal, jadi biar ketika kita mulai membuat media pembelajarannya, kita tidak terlalu kesulitan. Oh, ini dimulai dari titik apa, dia akan nge-sub kemana, subnya tadi kemudian lari kemana lagi, dan alirannya seperti apa, itu sudah kita definisikan. Nah, di sini yang paling umum adalah multi-level or tree. Berarti dia dari mulai atas, kemudian nanti kemudian apa namanya, kayak semacam kayak seperti apa kalau kita punya itu apa website misalkan contohnya. Jadi dari mulai home kita punya menu apa saja, menu-menu tadi dia punya sub apa saja, di situ di dalamnya kita sudah petakan. Berikutnya misalkan ini contohnya adalah yang dimiliki oleh kayak misalkan kita wizard or maybe we can make teaching media by PowerPoint or Google Slides. The process is like slideshow. Next or next back like that. Maybe sometimes we need to make teaching media about how process flow or something like that. The main point is you can say back and next link. And then the next we can say pyramid, variant of the stepwise model, use a hub page or menu page. This is different with the tree. Ya, perbedaannya dengan tree adalah kalau tadi itu hanya dia dari bis kembalinya ke atas, kalau di piramid adalah satu memungkinkan dari satu sub tadi dia bisa berkomunikasi dengan sub-sub yang lainnya masih di bawah hub yang sama. Ini mungkin kebanyakan arahnya juga sekarang sudah ke piramid. Okay, next about visual design. Visual design is more than just skinning a user interface. Jadi visualisasi itu tidak cuman kita hanya memberikan sebuah baju ataupun sebuah kulit pada sebuah tampilan antar muka. Jadi di sini bagaimana dia merasa enak dilihat, kemudian memang betul-betul orang yang melihat itu tidak merasa negatif ketika pertama kali melihat. Nah, itu jadi saya mengatakan ya kesan pertama itu memang sesuatu hal yang sangat penting. The visual design can make or break the usability of a product and trust in your brand. Nah, poin penting, main point in this slide is usability of a product and trust in your brand. Jadi, ketika seseorang sudah tidak merasa nyaman menggunakan perangkat atau media pembelajaran yang kita buat, siswa tadi sangat besar kemungkinan mereka tidak akan menggunakan itu untuk mempelajarinya, untuk kemudian belajar. Oke, di visual design saya sedikit membahas tentang warna. Warna mungkin banyak yang main tabrak warna, gimana Pak? Boleh enggak? Ya boleh saja, selama memang dalam batasan yang memang itu nyaman dari sisi pengguna. Saya selalu menggunakan color wheel. Ini selalu menjadi pattern yang istilahnya pasti. Jadi kami misalkan misalkan contohnya nih, selalu letakkan latar depan gelap dan kemudian dengan latar, jadi misalkan fontnya misalkan dengan menggunakan warna terang, nanti bentuk buttonnya dia menggunakan warnanya gelap ataupun sebaliknya. Dan kemudian istilahnya hindari kombinasi warna tertentu, misalkan nih teks biru cerah dengan latar belakang merah cerah, ini akan membuat mata itu menjadi cepat lelah. Makanya salah satu contohnya mungkin ketika kita bicara background, nanti ada juga saya bahas ketika kita bicara light or dark background, itu salah satu yang berkaitan juga dengan bagaimana mata pengguna itu nyaman untuk melihat. Nah, jadi contohnya mungkin ini, membaca teks hitam pada layar belakang putih, itu mungkin beberapa orang merasa nyaman, ya, tidak terlalu melelahkan mata. Tapi biasanya akan lebih bagus adalah teks belakangnya itu gelap, kemudian fontnya tadi menggunakan font yang putih, karena biasanya akan kombinasi sebagian besar menjadi lebih gelap, dan itu tidak membuat mata menjadi terang. Mungkin kalau warna ini, contohnya di Bu Ani tadi, mungkin akan sangat cocok banyak bermain warna. Karena di usia 5 sampai dengan 12 tahun, mereka masih belajar tentang warna, mereka masih sangat tertarik dengan sesuatu yang colorful. Nah, itu sangat cocok. Tapi dengan catatan tadi, ada beberapa hal. Mungkin kalau untuk anak-anak masih menganggap, it's funny when we can say a lot of color, but from the adult, misalkan untuk anak-anak yang sudah di SMP, SMA, misalkan, atau mungkin di perguruan tinggi, dengan melihat warna yang banyak, pasti kalau mungkin kita nyebutnya, wah ini terlalu colorful. Oke, next. Nah, ini ada dua warna, yaitu ada warm and cool. Jadi kalau ini lebih kepada ini. Yang pertama adalah bisa menggunakan warna ini, kombinasi warm dan cool bisa jadi satu, atau kita ternyata contohnya saya sangat lebih senang ke arah menggunakan warna cool. Tapi itu tidak selalu menjadi opsi utama ketika saya membuat sebuah media pembelajaran ataupun aplikasi ketika mendesain. Kenapa? Karena saya juga perlu melihat konteks dari aplikasi atau media pembelajaran tadi untuk apa. Ketika itu ingin menimbulkan sebuah semangat tertentu, keriangan tertentu, ya berarti saya memilih warna-warna yang warm, yang hangat, yang betul-betul kemudian membuat orang merasa semangat. Tapi ketika ternyata kita butuh membangun sebuah media pembelajaran yang membuat orang istilahnya mungkin agar tidak menjadi terlalu hype-nya tidak langsung naik semangat, tapi nanti turun lagi, nah bisa menggunakan warnanya yang cool. Tapi kombinasi sangat memungkinkan. Nah, kuncinya di mana tadi, di color wheel tadi, itu bisa menjadi patokan mana yang akan saya masukkan untuk dikombinasikan. Oke, kemudian background. Jadi background yang cerah dan yang gelap ini menjadi penentu juga. Ini menjadi, bisa dikatakan kalau saya itu lebih nyaman berada menggunakan background gelap, kemudian tulisan terang, itu tidak menjadi membuat terlalu capek. Kemudian warna kombinasi, nah ini salah satu yang saya ambil dari IG-nya Zain Arosyad, nanti tinggal dicari kempong gitu IG-nya, di situ dia banyak memasukkan beberapa example color combination. Nah ini maybe it's we can use this color combination to make design background, button, text, or maybe we want to put solid background like maybe in header like that, or we use maybe like this, we can use maroon. Kalau saya sebagai laki-laki, ini yang membuat beda dengan laki-laki dan perempuan, kadang pemahaman tentang warna itu sangat miskin. Jadi ini menurut saya ya merah maroon. Misalkan ternyata ada warna yang lainnya. Saya nggak tahu, mungkin kelemahan laki-laki. Oke, berikutnya tipografi. Nah, selain warna, tipografi juga penting. Di sini saya ini mencoba sedikit cepat ya waktunya. Oke, apa yang perlu diperhatikan di sini? Terkait tipografi adalah we use the typography it easy to read and not make the eyes of a human, tidak membuat mata manusia itu menjadi cepat lelah. Jadi contohnya serif di sini cenderung menjadi tipografi yang paling umum digunakan. Di sini huruf serif ini dia tidak terlalu membebani mata. Jadi ketika kalau kita ingin menggunakan sebuah di media pembelajaran tadi, kita ingin menampilkan banyak tulisan,
gunakan font-font yang serif. Cari di Google ada banyak sekali. Dan ini beberapa yang saya masukkan, ada Times New Roman, ada mungkin kenapa kok skripsi banyak menggunakan Times New Roman, ya alasannya ini. Dia tidak terlalu capek. Kemudian kalau di sans serif di sini, kalau bedanya dengan serif tadi memiliki garis di akhir huruf, ya. Tapi kalau di sans ini dia tidak memiliki garis. Kemudian di sini biasanya kalau sans serif ini banyak juga digunakan di contohnya di button-button ataupun di beberapa font-font yang itu dia tidak terlalu banyak secara tulisan, hanya ingin menampilkan misalkan kayak poin-poin penting tertentu. Kemudian ada juga yang ini bentuknya adalah display. Di sini display di sini biasanya mereka akan tampil dengan baik ketika mereka ditampilkan dengan ukuran yang besar. Nah, ini biasanya mereka digunakannya adalah untuk judul or title. Jadi, biasanya kita menggunakan huruf. Nah, ini perbedaan huruf ini saja sudah banyak. Nah, ini menjadi penentu juga kapan kita menggunakan huruf sans, kapan kita menggunakan huruf serif, kapan kita menggunakan sans serif, kapan menggunakan display. Ini salah satu hal yang nantinya juga mungkin Bapak Ibu ataupun teman-teman mahasiswa bisa pelajari karena berkaitan dengan teaching media pasti akan banyak menggunakan huruf selain warna tadi. Oke. Yang berikutnya adalah kita bicara tentang interaction design. Interaction design can be understood in simple. Jadi sebetulnya dia sesuatu yang simple, tapi tidak bisa dipahami secara simple juga. Jadi yang pasti adalah design the interaction between users and product. Jadi bagaimana antara manusia tadi, berarti student dengan media pembelajaran tadi dia berinteraksi. Yang pertama di sini saya menyampaikan ada 5 dimensi dari interaction design. Yang pertama we can say about word. Di sini word especially those used in interaction. Jadi tadi makanya kenapa kok font perlu. Nah, salah satunya kita juga harus tepat untuk menampilkan font tadi di posisi yang tepat juga. Maybe such as button, label. Kemudian yang kedua adalah visual representation. Visual representation ini berkaitan dengan gambar, kemudian icon. Nah, jangan sampai memasukkan sebuah icon, tapi itu membuat orang salah persepsi misalkan. Nah, itu juga harus betul-betul dipertimbangkan ketika kita akan menggunakan icon-icon tertentu. Kemudian yang berikutnya adalah physical object or space. Di sini media pembelajaran yang Bapak Ibu buat atau teman-teman mahasiswa buat tadi itu akan diakses dengan menggunakan apa? Menggunakan PC kah, menggunakan laptop kah, atau menggunakan smartphone? Nah, itu harus ditentukan di awal karena pasti ketika kita akan membuat itu pun akan menghasilkan desain yang berbeda. Oh, ketika anak murid saya banyak yang punya smartphone, ya jangan memaksa membuat sebuah media pembelajaran yang dibuat hanya bisa dibuka menggunakan PC. Nah, tentu akan menjadi kontradiktif. Berikutnya adalah di sini waktu di sini bahasanya gimana ya, paling gampang. Di sini di beberapa IDM ya, di beberapa buku kalau di interaction design waktu ini disebutkan adalah di era tertentu. Jadi waktu di sini sebenarnya dilihatnya dari adalah era. Oh, era sekarang banyak menggunakan misalkan video atau misalkan menggunakan animasi dibandingkan hanya menggunakan teks biasa ataupun hanya menggunakan sound saja. Nah, itu kita harus melihat kapan kita memasukkan itu juga di porsi yang tepat. Kemudian yang terakhir di sini adalah behavior. Jadi tadi mungkin kaitannya dengan physical object or space. Jadi kebiasaan orang itu dia seperti apa.
Jadi, nanti di start lagi nih.
Suatu produk ini mereka akan menggunakannya seperti apa. Nah, ini menjadi poin penting. Jangan sampai Bapak Ibu membuat sebuah media pembelajaran tapi ternyata tidak sesuai dengan apa yang dibutuhkan oleh murid-murid Bapak Ibu semua. Tentu akan menjadi sangat disayangkan. Oke, ini
banyak.
kalau Bapak Ibu bisa nanti ya, ini kalau tidak salah materi akan di share oleh panitia, nanti bisa di scan di situ. Salah satu yang kami banyak gunakan untuk kami apa ya presentasikan ke guru adalah salah satunya dengan menggunakan Google Site. Itu salah satu yang sekarang sangat cukup luar biasa untuk menghasilkan sebuah media pembelajaran, walaupun memang akhirnya terbentuknya adalah dia terbatas pada berbasis website misalkan. Tapi kalau tadi misalkan di game biasanya ada Constructo, kemudian saya juga menggunakan RPG Maker, nah itu yang juga saya gunakan di Bapak Ibu guru sekolah dasar itu sangat, mereka akhirnya kayak pembelajaran tematik itu biar menjadi sebuah cerita seperti apa, ya bisa dibuat menggunakan RPG Maker. Oke, terima kasih. Saya Dimas Sasongko dan ini email saya. Dan silakan bagi nanti yang kelihatannya mungkin tertarik untuk apa namanya bertanya, sudah disiapkan forum oleh panitia, nanti kita diskusi sama-sama, mungkin juga waktunya terbatas, misalkan nanti tidak semua bisa terjawab, saya mohon maaf. Begitu, terima kasih Pak, pas 30 menit, semoga tidak terlalu banyak memakan waktu. Kita akhiri, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much Bapak Dimas for delivering such a useful and informative material. Well, the distinguished all webinar participants, before coming to the Q&A session, we are going to have an interactive quiz carried out by QIP. QIP is an international affairs and marketing office. Please welcome Mr. Rafi.
Ya, terima kasih kepada moderator kita, Sir Benny Krisbiantoro. Oke, sebelumnya saya sapa dulu ya, saudara-saudara. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya lihat jam dulu ya, berarti sekarang selamat siang nih, karena udah masuk jam 11 ya, ternyata menjelang jam 11. Jadi saya ucapkan selamat siang untuk seluruh partisipan yang telah hadir. Gimana nih, masih pada semangat buat ikut kegiatan hari ini? Sampai nanti habis? Karena habis ini kita baru akan mulai sesi Q&A. Gimana masih bersemangat? Masih pada semangat ya. Nah, kalau gitu aku tanya balik deh. Buat materi tadi gimana? Seru kah? Atau mungkin ada yang merasa, aduh, kayaknya seru tapi kok ribet ya gitu. Gimana? Oke, ada yang jawab, very, very interesting. Kalau gitu kita lanjut aja ya. Nah, kalau tadi kita lagi agak serius-serius, sekarang kita rehat dulu sejenak. Kita agak santai-santai sedikit. Ada break, ada ngeet. Bukan ya, tapi ada break, ada quiz. Mana suaranya? Oke, ada break, ada quiz. Buat quiz kali ini akan ada dua jenis quiz, yaitu quiz yang aku sampaikan secara live di sini, dan satu lagi quiz yang akan kalian jawab di Instagram. Nah, akan dicari 5 pemenang beruntung yang akan mendapatkan hadiah berupa e-wallet sebesar Rp500.000 dipersembahkan oleh Yayasan Pendidikan Dwi Puspita. Oke, tanpa berlama-lama lagi, aku langsung aja ya kasih pertanyaan yang pertama. Tapi, pertanyaan yang ini khusus live aja dulu ya. Dan rules-nya kalian harus kasih emoticon raise hand dulu. raise hand dulu, baru dijawab. Jangan langsung digas, langsung jawab. Karena nanti pertanyaannya akan hangus dan nggak akan dapat hadiahnya. Oke, jadi siap-siap langsung cari emoticon raise hand-nya ya. Oke, udah standby semua? Oke, sekarang aku sebut ya. Pertanyaan yang pertama. Ditusuk bukan sate, dijaring bukan ikan. Apakah aku? Oke, ada yang sudah angkat tangan. Siapa tadi Rizka namanya? Mana Rizka? Bisa on kameranya terlebih dahulu? Oke, halo Mbak Rizka.
I'm not sure because...
Gimana Mbak?
I'm clicking.
Oke, tadi pertanyaannya...
No, I'm not want to answer.
Jaring bukan ikan. Jawabannya apa Mbak Rizka? Oke, kalau gitu nggak dijawab. Kita coba cari Alima. Oke, kita ganti. Ada Mbak Triani. Oke, Mbak Triani, halo.
Ya, halo.
Ya, halo. Gimana Mbak? Udah tahu jawabannya?
Konde.
Iya, betul. Rp100.000 untuk Mbak Triani. Ini Mbak Triani, nama lengkapnya siapa? Terus asalnya dari mana nih Mbak?
Ya, my full name is only Triani.
Oh, Triani aja ya. Asalnya ya, dari?
Cilacap.
Cilacap, nggak jauh
Macina
lah ya.
Macina.
Bisa nanti kapan-kapan main kesini, oke?
Okay? Iya.
Oke, okay, selamat ya Mbak Triani ya, mendapatkan Rp100.000 dipersembahkan oleh Yayasan Pendidikan Dwi Puspita. Selamat, jangan lupa nanti untuk kasih nama dan nomor HP-nya, nanti akan dikontak oleh panitia.
Oke, okay. Terima
bisa
kasih.
Bisa dikasih langsung di kolom komentar ya Mbak ya, atau di chat. Oke,
okay. Okay.
Pertanyaan kedua. Siap-siap semua, cari emoticon raise hand-nya. Oke, udah siap? Kita lanjut pertanyaan kedua. Aku adalah penyanyi luar negeri yang susah menelan.
Penyanyi luar negeri?
Apakah aku?
Yang susah?
Aku adalah penyanyi asal luar negeri yang susah menelan. Siapakah aku? Oke, mungkin Ellen
yang penyanyi jawab. Luar negeri yang susah itu menelan.
Hah? Tolong jangan dijawab dulu ya, raise hand dulu, nanti aku panggil. Ada Mbak, siapa itu namanya? Siapa? Oh, Mbak Nafa, halo Mbak Nafa.
Iya.
Oke, apa jawabannya nih Mbak buat pertanyaan kedua?
Ed seret,
betul banget, Rp100.000 buat Mbak Nafa. Mbak Nafa, saya dari mana nih Mbak?
Dari sini aja, Magelang.
Oh, sini aja Magelang, tapi kalau dari aku ke sana ya lumayan jauh lah ya. Oke, okay. Selamat ya Mbak ya, udah menang hadiahnya Rp100.000. Tolong nanti dikirim nama dan nomor teleponnya dan nanti akan dihubungi oleh panitia. Selamat ya Mbak.
Baik, makasih.
Oke, okay. Nah buat pertanyaan live-nya sudah beres. Sekarang ada 3 pertanyaan untuk dijawab di Instagram. Tapi pertanyaannya
seperti
sekarang di live sini ya. Nah, buat pertanyaan ini ada peraturannya lagi. Yang pertama, yang mau menjawab harus memfollow kemudian subscribe daripada akun UHB. Follow IG-nya di @universitasharapanbangsa dan subscribe YouTube-nya di Universitas Harapan Bangsa. Kemudian kalian bisa langsung jawab pertanyaannya di kolom komentar pada postingan flyer webinar hari ini. Jadi kalau misalkan udah kemarin lihat tuh di IG ada postingannya webinar hari ini. Nah, itu langsung dijawab di kolom komentar dengan format Q1 untuk jawaban soal pertama, Q2 untuk jawaban soal kedua, dan Q3 untuk jawaban soal ketiga. Jangan lupa juga buat di-mention teman-temannya sebanyak 3 orang di kolom komentar, dan nanti yang terpilih akan di-uploadkan atau di-mention di Instagram UHB. Dan jawabannya akan ditunggu paling lambat pada pukul 00 dini hari malam nanti. Oke, siap lagi ya. Mungkin yang ini kan nggak bisa langsung jawab ya. Bisa dicatat dulu pertanyaannya biar langsung nanti dijawab. Biar nggak ketuker juga ya. Oke, pertanyaan yang pertama untuk di Instagram. Tukang-tukang apa yang kalau dipanggil nengok ke atas? Sekali lagi ya. Tukang-tukang apa yang kalau nengok dipanggil ke atas? Salah, kalau dipanggil nengok ke atas. Tukang-tukang apa yang kalau dipanggil nengok ke atas? Oke, itu pertanyaan pertama dengan kode Q1 untuk dijawab di Instagram ya. Oke, Yang selanjutnya, pertanyaan yang kedua. Ada 10 tentara. Dijawabnya di Instagram ya, bukan lewat kolom komentar atau chat. Tukang-tukang apa yang kau dipanggil nengok ke atas tadi ya. Ya, sekarang kita balik ke pertanyaan kedua. Ada tentara 10 atau ada 10 tentara, mati 1. Sisanya berapa? Ada tentara 10, mati 1, sisanya berapa? Ya, untuk pertanyaan ini kodenya Q2 bisa dijawab di kolom komentar postingan Instagram ya. Next, aku bakal sebutin pertanyaan yang ketiga. Pertanyaannya adalah, kenapa pohon mangga di depan rumah harus ditebang? Sekali lagi, kenapa pohon mangga di depan rumah harus ditebang? Untuk pertanyaan ketiga, kodenya Q3. Sekali lagi, untuk pertanyaan yang tadi aku sebutin, dari yang tukang-tukang apa yang dipanggil nengok ke atas, terus ada 10 tentara, mati 1, sisanya berapa, dan kenapa pohon mangga di depan rumah harus ditebang, itu dijawab di Instagram dengan kode Q1, Q2, Q3. Jadi nanti jawabnya, Q1 jawabannya apa dari pertanyaan pertama, Q2 jawabannya apa, Q3 jawabannya apa, terus kalian mention 3 teman kalian di situ. Nah, nanti pemenang terpilih akan mendapatkan hadiah masing-masing e-wallet sebesar Rp100.000 dipersembahkan oleh Yayasan Pendidikan Dwi Puspita. Oke, dan terakhir nih ada sedikit pemberitahuan juga buat kalian yang mau daftar di Universitas Harapan Bangsa, masih dibuka untuk gelombang pertama, pembukaan sampai dengan tanggal 31 Januari 2022 dengan banyak benefit yang bisa kalian raih. Bisa langsung kalian cek di Instagram buat tanya-tanya, atau yang udah tahu kontak personnya, bisa langsung hubungin kontak personnya atas nama Kak Uji dan Kak Erna. Oke, aku pamit undur diri. Sebelum pamit, aku mau ngingatkan sedikit, buat kalian para peserta yang belum absen, jangan lupa absen di linknya ya. Bisa langsung registrasi di situ, dan nanti absennya akan ditutup pada pukul 1 siang hari. Kalau gitu, aku Raffi pamit undur diri. Sekian, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dadah!
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Nanti dulu, ini Q&A.
Well, thank you very much to Mr. Raffi for such a fun, interesting, and challenging quiz. Congratulations to the all winners for the quiz. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now come to the Q&A session. I'd like to have one question for each speaker. Please use the raise hand feature in Zoom if you want directly ask your question. And then if you want to write your question, you can drop the question to the chat box. So let's see who wants to ask directly to the speaker. Please raise hand. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it seems that we have several questions on the chat box. The first question from Ibu Zulfitriani. This question is addressed to Ms. Tri Pujiani. Can you say how young learners have a great curiosity to try new things and give examples? So that question goes to Ibu Ani. Ibu Ani, you can answer this question.
Okay, thank you very much for the question, Mr. Benny and Bu Sulfitri. Yeah. Okay, about
curiosity in young learners? Yes, curiosity is the natural characteristic of young learners. Yeah, maybe we often heard that children frequently ask, what is this? What is that? What is it? Why is it like this? Why is it like that? Yeah, I believe that we often heard this kind of question from children. Yeah, this is the sign of the children's curiosity. And as an adult, we have to answer this question patiently and carefully, because the information that the children get will remain in their mind until they grow up. So I also suggest to all of us, yeah, be careful when we talk in front of the children, what you read, because children is also a good copycat. Yeah, you know what I mean, that when we say a bad word and then they imitate it, it's, I think it's very impolite, yeah, for children. And also, children usually tend to curious to try new things, like what adults do. Okay, so when they see the adult do this, and then they want to try also. So we as an adult should be able to be a good example in front of the children, actually. And we need also to explain to them which one they can do and which one they can't do, and the reason. Yeah, so by understanding the reason, I think the children will avoid to do that. For example, when they see a person smoking, and then maybe in their mind they curious, how is it like? Yeah, how is the taste? Okay. But we need to explain to them the danger of smoking, or yeah, or something like that. Okay, so that's the curiosity in children. Yeah, curious to ask about things and also to try new things. Yeah, I think that's my answer. I hope my explanation can answer your question, because I think the time is limited. So I answer this question very briefly. Thank you very much, Mr. Benny.
Thank you very much, Ms. Annie. Well, I'd like to invite the participant who want to ask directly. You can use raise hand feature for live question and answer. Well, the next question goes to Bapak Dimas. It's from Rizky. Halo Mr. Dimas, izin bertanya bagaimana caranya mendesain media yang baik untuk kelas yang terdiri dari banyak siswa, karena setiap siswa itu memiliki karakter atau cara pembelajaran yang berbeda-beda. Terima kasih. Itu pertanyaan dari Mbak Rizky ya, kepada Bapak Dimas Sasongko. Silakan Pak Dimas.
Baik, terima kasih Pak Benny. Jadi memang ketika kita melihat sebuah, misalkan kelas ya, walaupun memang memiliki apa tadi, memiliki banyak siswa yang secara secara karakteristik berbeda-beda, tetapi salah satu yang bisa dilakukan tadi itu dengan menggunakan personas tadi. Jadi mungkin saya nyebutnya adalah user research-nya. Jadi user research yang di kelas itu kita melakukan pengamatan satu persatu, kemudian nanti kita bisa menyimpulkan, menghasilkan satu buah persona yang satu atau dua persona yang itu kemudian memiliki gambaran yang walaupun tidak kemudian 100% bisa mewakili semuanya, tapi paling tidak dia memiliki presentasi yang besar, itu bisa mewakili semua dari yang ada di situ. Jadi misalkan contoh, kalau saya biasanya diawali, mungkin diawali dari yang pertama adalah bagaimana kemampuan mereka, misalkan karena berkaitan dengan penggunaan teknologi, misalkan kemampuan secara teknologi mereka seperti apa. Kemudian perangkat apa yang mereka gunakan. Kemudian mereka sudah familiar tidak, sudah familiar belum misalkan dengan searching, sudah familiar belum dengan istilahnya apa. Contohnya mungkin kalau anak-anak, kalau sebagian besar sekarang saya tanya apakah pernah main game, pasti semua jawabnya pasti pernah. Nah, dengan pernah itu sebetulnya bagi
bagi misalkan kita yang kemudian akan membuat sebuah karya game tadi, itu tentu akan menjadi lebih mudah. Kenapa? Berarti kita tidak terlalu kesulitan untuk menentukan batas bawah kita, game itu akan menjadi mudah seperti apa. Karena mereka sudah memiliki experience di situ. Kalau saya tadi, jadi jangan kemudian melihat secara keseluruhan, tapi dari keseluruhan tadi kita, ya memang atau tidak mau, kesulitan dari menghasilkan sebuah produk digital adalah di user research-nya. Itu yang butuh waktu panjang. Dapat personanya, kemudian baru dilarikan ke desainnya tadi. Jadi, kenapa kadang desain user research and design itu membutuhkan waktu dan biaya yang lebih besar daripada development-nya. Jadi, kayak misalkan saya mengajukan, ya ini contohnya misalkan hibah, penelitian kayak gitu. Di user research dan di desain itu dia membutuhkan anggaran yang lebih besar dibandingkan developernya. Kenapa? Karena waktunya lebih banyak dan itu tergantung berhasil tidaknya sistem ataupun media pembelajaran ataupun aplikasi tadi dibuat ya berdasarkan tadi user research dan desainnya. Jadi Mbak Rizky Fitri mungkin nanti bisa diawali dengan user research, kemudian dibuat persona, habis itu lari ke desainnya. Jadi jangan terlalu mengkhawatirkan kok banyak sekali muncul karakter. Nah, itu bisa di filter menjadi lebih spesifik, hanya menjadi satu atau dua karakter saja. Begitu Pak Benny, terima kasih.
Thank you Bapak Dimas for brilliant answer. Well, because we are restricted by the time, I think we finally come to the end of the webinar. If you want to ask more to the speakers, you can send an email to the speakers, yeah, and ask question. Well, the conclusion we can draw from what the speakers have presented is that we can utilize the power of technology to create interactive and challenging teaching media and to enhance our teaching skills so that our students will be highly motivated to mingle and interact during the teaching and learning process. I'd like to thank the speakers for the informative and interesting presentation and all the participants for the very active participation. Finally, let's give a big round of applause for the speakers and for you all. Thank you. I'd like to turn over the time to the master of ceremony.
Mr. Benny. Ladies and gentlemen, these are the agendas we have presented to you today. As we have finished the event, to all of you, don't forget to fill in the attendance before 1 p.m. because the link will be closed by the time and the certificate will be able to be downloaded after 2 hours after this event through the link shared on the chat box. Thank you very much for making time in your schedule to join us here. And I wish you all a pleasant day. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Menjadi bagian sebuah bangsa yang besar tidak membuat kami berpangku tangan begitu saja. Mengesampingkan kepentingan pribadi, memilih menjadi seorang berprofesi luhur. Berperan aktif, selalu peduli, dan berhati jujur. Sesederhana tersenyum, memberikan salam, meniadakan perbedaan.
bereksperimen untuk mencoba hal baru yang jarang membuahkan hasil, tidak mematahkan semangat kami untuk tetap melakukan yang terbaik. Menumbuhkan rasa kemandirian agar tidak bergantung pada hal lain. Siap bersaing, berjuang maksimal, mengenalkan siapa kita sebenarnya. Hari ini, mungkin kami masih berjuang membekali diri dengan ilmu. Agar nanti, kami siap untuk membanggakanmu.